Hello children, begin the day with the prayer. The whole day you will be satisfied. I am your science mom speaking. Hope you all are being safe with God's blessings. We are seeing the lesson Spots and Stripes Come Alive. So in this video, we are going to just recap the lesson. Animals are found all over the world. They range different from tiny ant to a huge elephant. Each of these animal types has unique and distinct features, and they differ from one another in many ways. Animals differ from each other in several ways. They may be different in terms of their appearance, movement, place of living, and nutrition. So in this lesson, we are going to see all these topics. Other than this, there is an important thing. We are in the situation to take care of animals. Right, let us move to the lesson. First, place of living. Animal lives in many different places. They occupy the places where they can able to survive. Mostly, the animals used to occupy the places like land, water, and on trees. For example, animals such as zebra, peacock, lion, ants, cats, and elephants live on land. Animals such as fishes, dolphins, prawns, and octopuses live in water. Those animals such as monkeys, crows, and squirrels live on trees. Some animals such as crocodiles, frogs, and turtles can live both on land and in water. Animals also live in hot as well as cold regions. For example, animals such as camels live in hot regions. Polar bear live in cold regions. Now, let us discuss about solitary animals and animals that live in groups. Animals that live in different places may live alone or in groups. For example, animals such as bears, turtles, and octopus live alone. These are called as solitary animals. Some other example of solitary animals are bear, turtle, praying mantis, frog, betta fish, koala, or some examples. Animals such as lions, zebras, horses, and ants live in groups. So these animals, they live in groups to find food and to protect themselves and their young ones. Animals that live in groups are called by special names. Some example of special names of animals are herd of elephants, swarm of bees, flock of birds, pod of dolphins, an army of ants, a caravan of camels. Now, we can see some example of animal families. So, here some jumbled words are given. You need to unscramble these words. First picture, a pack of wolves, a school of fishes, a gaggle of geese, a band of gorillas. Now, we can see about eating habit in animals. Animals also differ from one another in their eating habits. Based on this, animals can be of three types: herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Animals that feed only on plants are called as herbivore type of animals. Herba means plants and orus means eater. For example, elephant, cow, goat, sheep or herbivore animals. Carnivores. Animals that feed only on the flesh and meat of other animals are called as carnivore animals. Corn means flesh, orus means eater. For example, lion, tiger, leopard, cheetah or these animals are called carnivore animals. Omnivores. Animals that feed on plants as well as other animals are called as omnivore animals. Omni means all, orus means eater. For example, bear, crow and human also omnivore type of animals. Since animals eat different types of food, the parts of their mouth and teeth are suited to the type of food they eat. For example, many carnivore animals such as lions and tiger have a long, sharp and pointed front teeth for tearing their meat and strong back teeth for grinding the flesh. Many herbivore animals such as horses and cows have broad, flat teeth to chew and grind tough plant parts. Some animals have both the type of teeth. For example, many omnivore animals such as bears, squirrels and humans have both the types of teeth. These animals use their sharp pointed teeth to eat flesh and use their broad flat teeth to chew on plant parts. Some animals such as snakes and birds swallow their food on the whole without chewing. So these animals can't able to chew the food. So they swallow the food as it is. Some animals such as frogs and lizards use their long and sticky tongue to catch their food. For example, chameleon frogs. Now, let us discuss about the body covering of animals. Animals also distinctly differ from each other in their appearance and body coverings. Many animals have special body coverings on their skin for protection against external factors such as heat or cold and to prevent any infection. The types of body covering in animals are fur, scale, feather and shell. Fur is the hair that covers on animal's body. Fur helps the animal keep itself warm and also protects it from heat. Example, lion, cat and mouse. Scales. Scales are small hard plates that cover an animal's body. Scales help to protect the animals from harm. Example, fishes, snake and crocodile. Feathers. Feathers are flat, soft, lightweight covering seen on birds. Feathers help birds fly and also keep themselves warm. Example, peacock, parrot, eagle. Shell. Shell or stiff, hard covering seen in a wide variety of animals. Shells help animals to protect themselves. Example, snail, tortoise and turtle. Some animals may not have any special covering on their body. They may be just have smooth or rough skin. For example, a dolphin has a smooth skin while a toad has rough skin. The patterns on the body of animals such as zebras and deer blend into their surroundings that have tall grasses and other plants. This helps them hide and protect themselves from being spotted by their enemies. The patterns on animals such as tiger and cheetahs help them hide and catch their food easily. So these type of animals are called as camouflage animals. Movements in animals. Generally, animals move to find basic necessities such as food, water, and shelter. They also move to protect themselves from enemies. Animals may differ from each other in the way they move. Some examples of movement in animals are swimming, flying, hopping, crawling, running, and slithering. So, there is a wide diversity in the animals that live on our planet. Animals differ from one another in various ways. The most important ones being their appearance, the food they eat, the way they move, and the place they live in. Now, here is the concept map. So, what are the places of living in animals? Land, water, and on trees. Body covering in animals? Scales, feather, fur, and shell. Eating habits in animals? Herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. The movements in animals are swimming, flying, hopping, crawling, running, slithering. Both pet and stray animals need food, water, shelter, and safe surroundings to live in. We can help them by providing their needs and by not harming them in any way. So, it is our duty to take care of stray animals. Animal care. So, we saw there are two types of animals. They are pet animals and stray animals. How can we take care of them? By providing regular checkups, take walking, provide fresh water and healthy food, can maintain regular schedule for food and playtime. How about stray animals? Yes, we can place a bowl of food and water outside the house. If it is injured, we can take them to the doctor. Avoid discarding food in plastic bags. The glossary. Carnivores. Carnivores means animals that feed on the flesh and meat of other animals. Herbivores. Herbivores that feed only on plants. Omnivores. Animals that feed on plants as well as other animals. Diversity, a wide range of difference. Now it's time for question time. Fill-ups. A frog can live both on land and in water. Feathers help birds to fly and keep them warm. Animals that live alone are called as solitary animals. The body of a fish is covered with scales. Animals that eat only plants are called as herbivore animals. Choose the correct answer. Squirrels eat insects, nuts, and fruits. So they are omnivore animals. The fur protects a polar bear which lives in cold regions. The shell is the hard outer covering that protects a snail. Animals such as bears feed on plants as well as other animals. Herbivore animals have flat, broad teeth. True or false? Tigers have flat, broad teeth to grind tough plant parts. It's false because tigers have sharp pointed teeth to tear the flesh of other animal and herbivore type of animals will be having the flat broad teeth to grind the tough plant parts. Second one, humans are omnivore animals. Yes, of course, it is true, because humans will be eating both the plants as well as the animals, flesh of other animals. Next, lions have fur that keep them warm. Yes, it's true. Snakes use their long sticky tongue to catch the fruit. No, it's false, because snakes will be swallowing the food as it is. A turtle is an example of solitary animal. Yes, it's true. Thank you, children. Have a recap of this lesson once again. God bless you.